On the stage, okay, on the stage. Cool.
All right. Thank you, Jeff, for the great introduction to live up to it. So, hi, I'm Scott. I'm a senior living in 2B. So, I'm walking up a rusty staircase, a six-apartment, dilapidated tenement building on the outskirts of Tokyo. I find the apartment I'm looking for, 2-1 in bronze numerals. So why was I here, unsure of what lurked in this unknown apartment? I came here to work on a farm. There were no green fields around me, only telephone wires and gray storefronts as twilight swallowed my surroundings. There was no farm owner in sight either. So how did I get here? Backtracking a little bit, this was in June, the summer after my freshman year at Stanford. I didn't get any of the internships I applied for. I wanted to work in Japan that summer, a country I've loved and whose language I've studied since fourth grade. I was determined to travel there, though, so I signed up for a work exchange that needed no application. Secret, you can do this. I was to work on a farm exchange for room and board, a cheap way to travel. But part of why I was so desperate to get to Japan was because I wanted to run away from my problems at home at this time. I wanted to run away from a broken sense of self. That freshman year, I was confronted with a dizzying array of choices for clubs, commitments, and different paths of being. Did I want to be an academic, a writer, translator, ditch all of that and try out tech or finance, like so many other people seem to be wanting to do on campus? I took all the philosophy books I read in my classes perhaps a little too seriously, and I questioned all these life paths until I no longer knew what I wanted for my future. I had also broken up with a boyfriend I dated in high school who also just so happened to be accepted into Stanford, living in the floor above me in FLOMO. Messy. The breakup resulted in further doubt of who I was, since I realized I didn't know what I wanted out of my relationships, nor how I wanted to behave in my relationships, whether that be with lovers, friends, or family. Lastly, I was depressed, and I didn't know how to stop the racing thoughts that kept me up at night each night, and which ensured each day was like walking through a wall of dark molasses. During this time, I struggled with an eating disorder as well, and every problem seemed to feed into the other one. I thought that spending that summer innocently on a farm in a country I loved would wash away all my problems, but of course there would be problems as well. My farmer host was neither a farmer nor a host. He was running at this hostel illegally in this apartment building, renting out rooms that he himself was renting out from the old lady living next door. He had no permit to speak of, and at any moment, the authorities could come and break apart the whole venture. And the Japanese authorities are known to be strict. The work was unpleasant, too. I met the host only once between his scuttling around his different properties under the radar of the police. So I did not get the chance to connect with this man, which was part of the whole program. Instead of planting carrots and mulching furrows, I worked as a maid for the rooms. I was given $50 a week for a 1 week's worth of food, cleaning supplies, and coinage for laundering the guests' linens. Now, I acknowledge that people can and do live like this, but I am not used to that, and I was not prepared for it. And on top of this, my mind still kept on flicking back to these negative thoughts, often suicidal. So after a week, I decided I had to figure out an alternative farm that would host me on short notice. In between the host demands, I went to a cafe with Wi-Fi, and I did find a solution, one on Japan's northernmost island, Hokkaido. I had to use up more of my savings to get a flight up there, but thankfully this second farm was a success. I made friends with the hosts, didn't have to worry about shelling out money for food, but even in the calm there, I realized my personal issues were still with me, that they weren't going to go away without me directly addressing them. So over the years, at my time at Stanford, I've learned how to manage these problems, but I should have paid closer attention to one of the philosophers I studied, Ralph Waldo Emerson, who writes, pretty simply, traveling is a fool's paradise. So trying to pull an eat, pray, love after freshman year may not solve your problems, but putting in 10 hours a day at a tech job during the summer will not solve them either. Ultimately, if you find yourself struggling with internal problems, external distractions will not heal what some introspection, some time, simply, and maybe a little bit of therapy may heal. So I hope whatever struggles you're facing, find a way to some slice of internal paradise, even if it be a fool's. Thank you.